Even after the fire stopped, they couldn't move. Seven and the boy in the jacket simply stood where they were, frozen. The boy in the uniform collapsed, falling to the floor on a jumble of limbs like a puppet whose strings had been cut. A few more minutes passed. The door opened. The boy in the uniform ran in, stumbling over his own feet. Seven and the boy in the jacket followed, still too numb to speak. The air in the incinerator was hot. Every breath made Seven's lungs feel like they were on fire. The air shimmered with heat, and in the middle of the room, beneath the waves of heat, there it lay. The boy in the uniform walked toward it, his legs shaking violently. Seven couldn't see his face, but his body looked somehow empty. Finally, he reached it. The boy collapsed to his knees, his legs no longer able to support him. Das könnt ihr euch vorstellen.
Okay.
Dem kann man, glaube ich, nicht gerecht werden. Junpei felt a cold lump form in the pit of his stomach. A feeling of sickening anticipation washed over him. He could feel his body shivering. He desperately did not want to know the answer he feared he knew already, but he had to ask. He had to know for sure.
Can I ask you one more thing?
What?
The girl, Akane. What was her last name?
What does it matter to you?
Just tell me, okay, please?
Seven looked at Junpei curiously and ran his tongue quickly over his dry lips.
Kurashiki. Her name was Akane Kurashiki.
Something inside of Junpei stopped. He had no more words left. He had no more Junpei left. He was just a shell of flesh and bone. Seven turned to Snake.
You were there that day, weren't you? The tall kid in the jacket. That was you, wasn't it?
Yes, I was. You are correct, detective.
Junpei's mind was blank, withdrawn from the world. Somewhere, far away, he could hear Seven and Snake talking.
Don't misunderstand me. I told you before how Zero threatened me. There was nothing I could do. You couldn't say anything about what happened 9 years ago.
So you're saying you're not working for Zero, right?
Of course not.
Clover, what about you?
Hey, come on! You really think I'm working with Zero? I told you before, you idiot! I was in Nevada in Building Q. I did hear that a detective rescued the kids on the boat, but I didn't know it was you.
Her surprise seemed to be genuine. Ich finde übrigens auch gut, dass sie Seven als diesen bulligen Typen in so ein bisschen jetzt nicht den besten Klamotten darstellen, sodass man halt glaubt, er hat eher eine Gangster-Vergangenheit oder sowas. Also das ist die Assoziation, die man hat.
Man hat auch immer das Gefühl, dass er halt dumm ist. Weißt
genau,
du?
So ein bisschen
einfältig und dass er dann
halt klobig.
So ein Schläger ist oder sowas. Ja. Aber dass er halt ein guter Detektiv ist, der als einziger darauf das rauskommt, das ist, fand ich auch einen sehr, sehr tollen Twist.
Seven regarded Clover for a moment and rubbed his chin thoughtfully.
Well, I guess I believe you.
Clover nodded.
Alright, let me ask you another question.
He stuck his hands into his pockets and took a few steps. Then he stopped and turned to face them again.
Sansa's real name is Aoi Kurashiki. He's Akane's brother. You know that?
No, I didn't. Did you?
Well, I know Aoi Kurashiki was her brother, yes. But I didn't know he was Santa, at least not from the beginning. 9 years ago, he was in the middle of puberty. His voice is entirely different now. Like mine is at the time. I'm ashamed to say that even my exceptional hearing wasn't able to make that connection. As such, I had no reason to think Santa was Aoi. When did you figure it out?
A short time ago, Clover told me that Santa might have been one of the subjects of the initial experiment. When she told me that, I had a feeling.
Santa is Aoi. Akane Kurashiki, June's brother. That spark caught flame in Junpei's leaden mind, and the fog began to clear, like an engine beginning to turn. images and thoughts began to coalesce in his mind, coming faster and faster, forming bigger images, bigger thoughts. Junpei blinked. He was back.
There's still a lot we don't know. I mean, like, a lot. But there's one thing we can say we know.
What's that?
The body we found in the showroom had to be Nijisaki, dressed up to look like Snake.
What?
Come on, man, what kind of detective are you? You didn't figure that out already?
Hey, go easy on me, man. I just got my memory back, alright? Cut me some slack.
Well, if he is, the three murders make sense then, don't they? Yeah, that's right, murder. Kuota blew himself up, but that was murder too. So why did these murders take place?
If Junpei is correct and the body in the showroom was Nijisaki's, that means all of the people who were murdered were involved with the creation of the Nonary project.
Kubota, the person who conducted the actual experiments. Nijisaki, Hongu's assistant. Musashido, the man who financed the project.
You mean this was all just revenge? Senta is zero? He's getting revenge for the death of his sister. No, I don't think Senta actually murdered anyone.
In fact, Junpei didn't think, he knew. He couldn't explain why or how, but he had no doubt that Senta had killed no one. Perhaps the madness of the last several hours was finally driving him insane, but Junpei had ceased to be surprised at the sudden knowledge, and had even begun to accept it.
If I'm right, then it's not hard to figure out who the next victim's gonna be, is it? I'm pretty sure I don't have to tell you.
Snake Clover and 701 nodded.
The next target will be Gentaro Hongo, the person who planned the Nonary project.
In other words, Ace.
There was a moment of silence.
Plötzlich sah ganz weird aus.
And then the room shook. From far away, they heard a sudden rush of water.
Whoa, what the hell is going on?
It must be 6 a.m. Our time is up.
Shit!
Come on, we need to get out of here. How?
In the drawer that he had held the picture was a keycard. Junpei grabbed it.
I'm betting this sucker opens the exit. Come on, let's go.
New material has been added to the fight screen. Zero.
Na dann, auf, auf.
Let's go.
Nach links.
Ja. Let's go.
Alright, let's just swipe this card. Junpei, look. It's unlocked.
Yeah, now we can go back to the library.
Hurry up, Junpei. Nein, was ist das für eine Stimme? We don't have time. Let's go.
Let's go. Snake.
Alright. Let's go.
Wir sind ja auch noch in einem Raum.
Ja, dieser Raum in dem Walkthrough wurde der als Zero's Laboratory benannt.
Zero's Laboratory. The door opened and they stumbled into the library. The shaking had stopped, but they knew the danger hadn't passed. They ran across the hallway straight for the large metal door. Next to the door was the Uranus card reader. They slid the keycard through and the door rumbled open. Out of the library and into the hallway they ran. At the end of the hallway was a door. Junpei reached into his pocket to pull out the key as he ran toward it. The key he put into the lock was the Neptune key. He turned it. The lock clicked. As one, they shoved the door open and poured through it. In front of them was another great metal door. Above it was a metal plaque. It read Incinerator.
So this is the incinerator.
This is the first time I've seen it from this side, but yeah, I think so.
Then there ought to be a lever near the door. Yep, right here.
Junpei ran up to it.
Pull that and the door should open. Got it.
As he spoke, he pulled the lever.
He solved it.
The motor in the door groaned as it slowly opened. Slowly ground open. There was no time to waste. As soon as the door had opened far enough to admit them, all four dashed through. Then suddenly, there before them were the four who they'd parted from earlier. Ace and Lotus stood in front of the number 9 door. Santa was curled into a ball against the wall of the incinerator, holding his stomach. And then there was June. She sat slumped against the wall, exhausted. What had happened? Junpei ran toward June. He skidded to a stop in front of her and knelt down.
What's wrong? Are you okay?
Her face was pale and her lips dry. When she spoke, he could barely hear her.
Jumpy, you came to get me. Of course I did. I made a promise. I'm so glad you're here. So glad.
She mumbled the same words over and over weakly. Junpei could feel his heart breaking.
Hey, what happened to you? I'm fine. I just fainted. I wasn't feeling very good. I'm feeling a lot better now, though.
Are you sure?
Yes. I just need to rest a little longer. I'm sure I'll be fine. You shouldn't worry about me.
She was looking toward Santa. Junpei turned to look as well. Santa grimaced, his face contorted in pain. Seven grabbed him by the collar and roared at him.
Hey, where is it? Where's the gun? You hide it somewhere? Ugh.
Despite himself, a grunt of pain escaped Santa's lips as Seven shook him.
I don't have it. I got sucker punched and I took the gun. Who took it?
What, isn't it obvious?
I took the gun. Wie hast du ihn nicht gesehen?
Ace! Du hast in diesem leeren, runden Raum versteckt.
Ne, sie haben ja gesagt, sie standen bei der Tür, aber dass sie dann wahrscheinlich mit dem Rücken oder so. He did indeed have the revolver in his hand. It was pressed against Lotus' temple. Ace had her pinned to him with the other arm and she was shaking visibly. Her fiery attitude was gone, replaced by fear. She didn't dare speak. There was sweat on her forehead, and when her eyes went flicking up to the gun pressed against her, they seemed to desperately want to say something.
Just what the hell do you think you're doing, Ace? Or maybe I ought to say, Genteru Honguro, CEO of Cradle Pharmaceutical!
Seven's deep baritone rumbled, shook the walls. Ace sneered.
You have me at a disadvantage, and I don't like that. You know me, but I don't know you. Do you have any idea how much I've suffered? Can you even begin to understand my pain? The pain of prosopagnosia, fuck! Stick it real, right?
Das war doch fast richtig. Ja. Junpei's voice was casual, or at least it was trying to be.
Another irritating insect. And how do you know that, hmm?
Junpei couldn't say, he just knew. Another unexplainable mystery.
No matter. If you don't want to answer, it makes no difference to me. This is a waste of time anyway. It's time for me to go.
Behind Ace, Junpei could see the rat. It was placed in a small indentation on the wall. Quickly, Ace placed his hand on the scanner. It beeped and he forced Lotus's hand onto it as well. Then at last he reached into the pocket of his jacket, he pulled something out and pressed it against the panel. The third asterisk appeared on the red. The thing he had used for the final verification was the bracelet with the number 9. It had belonged to the first man to die, Kubota.
Also ist das auch eine 9? Dann gibt's auch zwei 9.
Oh, so it seems.
Oh, I believe I won this game.
His smirk made Junpei's blood boil.
I've had quite a time playing with you. I must thank Zero, I suppose.
Wait, something about the way he'd spoken. Did Ace not know who Zero was? Junpei's eyes flicked towards Santa. He hadn't moved since they'd entered the room. Santa was still holding his stomach and groaning as if in immense pain. Junpei wasn't sure it was real pain, but he wasn't sure it wasn't either. What the hell did Santa have up his sleeve this time?
At any rate, this game ends now. I will escape and the rest of you will have a slightly less pleasant ending. I suggest you enjoy your final moments. Goodbye. Wait!
Ace, of course, paid no heed to Seven's request and laid hold of the lever on the rat. With a sickening sense of finality, he pulled it.
Haha, da habe ich zu früh geredet. Dass du dich noch an sowas erinnerst.
What? Why isn't it opening?
Das war gerade übrigens keine Erinnerung, das war eine Vermutung. Ich hätte genauso gut falsch liegen können. aber nachdem die anderen Zahlen schon anders waren. Ja, ja. Lotus tried to take advantage of Ace's confusion and managed to twist herself out of his grasp, but at the last second he grabbed hold of her wrist and shoved it onto the red. He waved the number 9 bracelet over the red and then his own bracelet as well. He pulled the lever a second time.
No. What is this? Why? The digital route should be 9. It has to be 9. Why isn't it opening?
Error. Ace's fury and confusion had overridden all other thoughts. He had set down the revolver. It was just below the red. Seven chose that moment to act. He moved far faster than a man of his bulk should have been able to, and he launched that bulk straight at Ace. Was steht da? Achso. Das ist schön dargestellt. It was over before they knew it. In the blink of an eye, Ace was on the floor. He rolled onto the side, groaning in pain. Lotus ran straight for Junpei. She darted around behind him and stuck her head out, making sure to keep Junpei between herself and Ace.
Phew. That was close, too close. Thank you, Seven.
Don't mention it.
Seven stood over Ace's, breathing slow and heavy.
Just one punch and enough for this piece of shit. After what he did 9 years ago, I ought to rip him to pieces. But if a suspect can't talk, there ain't much good. Once he's locked up in a cell, we're gonna have a little chat. 9 years ago? Ah, then you must be... Yeah, you finally figured out. Dumbass.
Ace planted his hands on the floor and shook his head. Junpei walked toward him. He stopped and looked down at Ace with pity on his face.
Ace, you killed Kubota, Nijisaki and Musashiro, didn't you?
Wait, Nijisaki?
He peered at Junpei, genuinely confused.
Oh, right. You don't know yet.
Alright, we'll just go through them in order then. Let's start off with Kubota. You talked to Kubota and managed to convince him to go into door number 5 alone. You killed him without making it look like you killed him. The way I figure it, you had 4 motives. 1.
Werden die Motive erklärt. Oder? Ja, mach mal, ich hab schon so viel gehört.
In the nonary game, the number 9 was dangerous. Whoever had this number had the number 9 bracelet could join whatever team they wanted. You could add 9 to any number and the digital route would never change. Da zum Beispiel, oder auch da, oder hier ebenfalls. In other words, number 9 could do whatever they wanted. Ace had wanted to remove that threat as soon as possible. 2. Ace also wanted to have the number 9 bracelet himself, so that he could make use of its power. In fact, he later made use of it in the murder of Nijisaki. 3. Even if his number had been different, Kubota presented a problem for Ace. Kubota had known Ace's past. He knew what had happened 9 years before. Before he told anyone, Ace had to silence him. 4. But last and perhaps most disturbing, Ace had used Kubota as a test. He wanted to know how serious this no-name game was. Was it truly life or death or simply a harmless prank? He convinced Kubota to break the rules so that he might see what happened. That was why you killed Kubota. But he was only the first. Next was Nijisaki. While everyone was off looking for the missing part of the rat, you ran into Nijisaki near the big hospital room. Ich wusste halt, dass man das Bild schon gesehen hat und deswegen meinte ich, man kann ihn auch ein bisschen wiedererkennen, eigentlich wirklich. However, because of your prosopagnosia, you didn't realize he was Nijisaki. Chiefly because when you met him, he was dressed as Snake. That was why you thought Nijisaki was Snake. No, that's not... That was Nijisaki? How did... I'll get to that. Anyway, you thought he was Snake. Snake was one of the kids in your experiment 9 years ago. You remembered him because he was the blind kid. But his presence made you think. Snake was one of my subjects 9 years ago. He probably hates me. But if that's true, why isn't he saying anything? Is he keeping quiet because he can't see? Or perhaps he's working with Zero to get revenge on me? Whatever the reason, anyone who knows my past is a threat. Before he tries anything, I need to get rid of him. That was when you decided
you had to kill him. The murder weapon was Kubota's bracelet. You just waved it over the rat, verified your own number, and then grabbed Nijisaki's arm and forced it over the scanner panel. Then when the door opened, you kicked him in. 9 seconds later, the door closed. And then 81 seconds passed. And poor Nijisaki was dead.
Then you mean to say Snake is still alive? Sorry to disappoint you, but I'm good as new. Thank you for killing the wrong man, but I can't say I like knowing that you wanted me dead. Although, to be honest, if you hadn't tried to kill me, I would still hate you very much. Ah, well, I wouldn't blame you.
Ace's self-derision was frustrating, but Junpei kept his emotions in check and continued.
Last but not least, let's talk about Musashiro's death. When Clover and I were investigating the chart room, you came over to talk to me. Do you remember what you said?
Pocket watch. Might I take a look at it?
I handed you the pocket watch and you left the room.
Ace had been in charge of the Nonary project. He would, of course, have known the solution to every puzzle. It followed then that he knew how to get out of the wheelhouse. All Ace had to do was place the pocket watch in the indentation on the door to unlock it.
Ich glaube, das ist, wenn ich das lese, weil das ja alles so ein bisschen Erklärung ist.
Ich glaube, es ist nicht ganz so dramatisch. With the door open, he was able to enter the captain's quarters. Musashiro was there. Next to him was an axe that fairly begged Ace to kill Musashiro with it. He picked up the axe and swung it, burying the blade deep in the other man's chest. Gutes Geräusch. One blow was all it took. Afterwards, Ace returned to the chart room as though nothing had happened. There was something I wanted to speak with you about, Junpei. Could you come with me for a moment? With no reason not to, Junpei had followed Ace to the wheelhouse. When they reached the wheelhouse, Ace slipped his hand into Junpei's vest. He pulled out a piece of paper, the piece of paper Junpei had used to cheat during the vote. But it wasn't the piece of paper that Ace was after. His true purpose had been to slip the pocket watch into Junpei's pocket. It wasn't a very good plan and had far too many flaws, and the wrong word of discovery could easily have toppled it. What had made Ace so desperate? That was the only thing Junpei hadn't been able to figure out.
Musashiro's murder is the only one I don't understand.
Siehst du, und jetzt ist er doch über dritte Person über Junpei, also waren es nicht seine Erklärungen.
Aber der Rest hat...
die Erzählererklärung.
Weird.
Ich mag aber grundsätzlich den Ansatz, den wir hatten, das so zwei zu teilen, untere Ohrerbildschirm.
You obviously did it, but why? Because of this.
Slowly, Ace reached down and pulled something out of his pocket. It was a folded piece of paper. Junpei took it and opened it. This was what it said. Number one. There are two ways you might survive this ordeal. The first is to win the Nonary game. The second is for you to confess your sins of 9 years past. I have prepared a camera in the captain's quarters. The images captured by the camera will be streamed through a satellite and distributed across the world. Simply look into the camera and repent. Once you have confessed everything, I will release you from this ship. To make your confession more credible, I have left you with a witness in the captain's quarters. Perhaps he will confess with you. The decision is yours. Do as you please. Zero.
When I awoke in that room on D-Deck, I found it in my pocket. That was why I chose door number one when we voted. If I went through that door, I knew I could get to the captain's quarters. As you said, I knew how to enter the wheelhouse. My plan was to find the pocket watch before anyone else. If I could, then my alibi would be set. At least that was the plan. Unfortunately for me, you got to it first. That sleight of hand was the best I could manage on short notice. You meant to kill him from the beginning then? Musashiro, I mean. I only knew Musashiro was the witness after I reached the captain's quarters. I asked him and he answered. He seemed groggy. Perhaps he had only just awoken from sedation. I suppose Nijisaki was in much the same state. He seemed confused and disoriented when I encountered him. But yes, you are correct. I intended to kill him from the beginning, even though I didn't know who he was.
I proceeded to the captain's quarters in order to remove this so-called witness.
Ace had confessed everything. What energy he had left with him, what energy he had left him with the truth, and he sagged on his knees. Although he had confessed, his sins were not forgiven. Junpei felt revulsion for the pathetic man on the floor near his feet. But in among the revulsion was a hint of pity. After all, Ace had not been the only person who murdered those three men. Junpei spoke quietly.
Ace, you figured it out, haven't you? You were being manipulated. Yes, so it would seem. I was little more than a puppet in many ways. Everywhere I went, everything was already prepared. The rats in the large hospital room were dismantled. Nijisaki was dressed like Snake. There was an axe in the captain's quarters. Musashiro was delirious from the anesthetic, so he couldn't fight back. Nijisaki as well. In retrospect, I can't understand how I could have fallen into such a simple trap. I'm quite ashamed of myself. But yes, yes, this was a trap. It was the worst trap, and I fell for it hook, line, and sinker. I did everything he wanted me to do. Yeah. By manipulating Ace, Zero was able to kill three people and keep the blood off his own hands. All of this was revenge for what happened 9 years ago. That's why this non-every game happened. Am I right, Santa?
Junpei looked over at Santa. As Junpei spoke, he stood up, his legs still shaky.
Huh? What the hell are you talking about? I don't know any. Ain't no point trying to play dumb anymore, Santa. Actually, I guess I could call you Aoi Kurashiki, huh?
Seven's face was sad as he spoke.
My memory came back, kid. You are Aoi Kurashiki, no doubt about it. Never thought I'd be back in this room, talking to you. But hey, I guess this was all part of your plan, right? After all, the person who planned the nonary game this time around was Zero. And Zero's you. Heh. Looks like you really do have your memories back, huh?
Santa's smile was sarcastic and something else.
Well, I guess there's no point in hiding it. There, you got me. I'm Aoi Kurashiki. I was one of the kids in Nonary Game 9 years ago. I made it out, so did Snake over there. But there's one thing. No, I guess there are two things you got wrong. Number one, I ain't Zero. What? Wait, what?